Good evening, everyone. Today we have with us Dr. Prabhash Bose, who is the Director of College of Engineering and Management, Kolhapur. Welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Okay, sir. Sir, thank you for being with us today. So, sir, I wanted to ask you, sir, being the Director of College of Engineering and Management, what is your philosophy of leadership? How would you describe your leadership style?
Actually, I was a person who was in uniform for 30 years, who was busy in maintaining the territorial integrity of our country. So leadership comes automatically to us. And the philosophy is the students, they're the topmost priority. And my leadership style is take everyone together, work as a team to achieve the success. There is nothing like individual, it's a team, and I'm privileged to lead the team in College of Engineering Management, Kolhapur.
Certainly, sir. And sir, my next question would be, the education systems in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently. In your experience, sir, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in your institute?
Oh, exactly. It is different because from our experience, you can see the course curriculum which is being designed by our university, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad University of Technology, or MACAUT in short. They get the guidance or the guideline from AICT New Delhi. So, and if you go through the complete course curriculum designed by AICT, it is at par with all the global universities of the world. And that the proof is that our students, when they are going for higher studies in IITs or other universities in India, or going abroad for MS or PhD, they do not find it any difficulty or any problem on the course structure. So it is at par with the global structure, and our students, they are doing very well, and the foundation they are getting from our college only by educating by our teachers. So there is no difference at all there in the course structure.
Sure, sir. So what do you think should be the institute's top priority over the next 10 years?
As all of us know, this is the new education policy 2020, which is being inaugurated by our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. And that is the top priority of all the institute of India. And we have also conducted a series of webinars on NEP 2020 so that we know what to do. Along with NEP 2020, we have the priority on accreditation. Then we have to go for the NIRF ranking. And we have to increase the scope of getting government job by our students. And we have already started GATE coaching, combined engineering services coaching, and how to join defense forces, because it's a very big scope for the technical graduate to do well in the defense forces. So we're also training them. We must give more emphasis in these areas.
Agreed, sir. Sir, what do you think are your roles and responsibilities to the college and to the students as the director of the institute?
As I told you earlier, students, they're the topmost priority for us, and whatever we're doing for them, because it is very clear, as long as the students are with us, we are existing. Without student, we do not exist. And in this pandemic scenario, we are understanding when the students have gone online and the complete campus is lying empty. It's like you are in the college doing nothing, though we are busy in online classes. So students are the top priority. Other than that, our responsibility is a smooth running of the college, welfare of all the employees. Then we are going to connect to the alumni, and we are near future going to register our alumni association. And we always imbibe the culture of lifelong learning for the students and smooth transition from studentship to professionalism so that they can do well in their future. And most importantly, a student should be able to contribute to the society. And then with think our responsibility, we are really going ahead with our responsibility.
Yes, sir. Students are certainly an important part of any institute.
Yes.
So, sir, in line with it, what would you like people to know about your institute that they may not already know about it, especially students?
Yeah, this is actually a college of 23 years track record. So our college is not new. We are one of the oldest self-aided college. So we are already having a lot of visibility, but in addition to that, then we are providing the R&D and academic ambience to all the students. Then our faculty, they're 24/7 available, and they are from industry, because we have faculty, they have served in industry. From there, they have gone for the higher studies and they have joined the academia. So that mixture of industry, academia experience is there. And all the latest things, you may call it 3D printing, the robot, you can call it the CNC machine, then quadcopter, then IoT, then artificial intelligence, electric vehicle, everything is available with us. And it's all live. The students can actually learn this hands-on from all this. Other than that, we are organizing webinar. Then we have NCC, NSS, then Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, which is the flagship of Government of India. Then the Rural Technology Action Group, where the students are able to take the technology to a rural area. They can be used for the benefit of the people. Then we are the recognized institution of Swachhata Action Plan and Rural Entrepreneurship Development of MHRD. And then we are also signed the pledge of reduction of carbon footprint. So it's very, very big thing the college is doing. Other than that, we're the student chapter of NPTEL and IIRS and ISRO Nodal Center. So the basket is quite big for our college.
Yes, sir. So, sir, what are some plans that you're currently or will be designing for your students?
Yeah, with this new normal, we have already adopted the online teaching. We're having a 350 Mbps online system. The service provider is doing an excellent job. Then we are having the virtual lab. Those are already started, it's going on. And then we're starting the hybrid mode of teaching. When the students come back, the new normal will continue. So we'll be having both online and person-to-person classes, that is a hybrid mode. And for that, we're also establishing a proper studio from where a teacher can come and take class, and it can be straightaway transmitted to the students who are not in the class. Then we are giving more thrust on innovation, on startup. Then, as I told you, the Rural Entrepreneurship Development and Industry Institute Partnership Cell, which will be giving the idea what way the industry is looking for and how best we can modify and motivate our student to be a contributor to the industry. This is the plan.
So this plans are really great to hear. So my next question would be, do you have any extracurricular activities or programs to enhance the skills of the students or expose them to the real world challenges?
Yeah, it is seen that the boys, they may be academically very good, but socially they are not very acceptable. So our university has designed a program that is known as mandatory additional requirement, where a student gets a exposure to nurture his passion, his talent, and it gives a confidence for doing good. We're having around 10 clubs are there, which is including robotic club, where the club it's dealing with the art and culture. Then they are having the debate. Okay. Then they are also going for group discussion. All these things are there that gives an ample opportunity for the students for the self-development. Then the students, they organize technical festival and cultural festival. So they learn how to manage an event. Of course, the guidance are there from the teachers. And other than that, we always motivate them, go for tree plantation, adopt the local village, Then during the pandemic, our students were associated to make the sanitizer and distribute to the local people. So things are going on for the extracurricular activities so that there is having some aim where the student can get the self-development.
Yes, sir. So my last question for the day would be, do you have any suggestions you would like to give the current youth and the aspiring students?
Yeah, if you say the current youth, they're the actual the students, those who are already with us. We always tell them on the day one, they enjoy the college life, there is freedom, but do not get deviated from the main focus. And we tell the parents also at the same time when they come to us, please remain connected with us, because your word will remain with you. Only 4 years you have given to us to make a professional out of them. So we are doing it. At the same time, remain connected. And social networking, Google, YouTube, those are very good for now, today's generation, but that should be used very, very judiciously. And learning windows must remain open. They should not say, okay, we have the Google with us, so we know everything. But experience is also a very, very big thing which needs to be respected. When they go to the industry, they may find someone below his cadre, his vast experience. They must learn from them, and they have that learning window open. And those who are aspiring and ready to start their career for that, I'll say all the fields are very, very good and huge scope is there. Only thing, you have to do well. Whatever you do, you have to do it passionately. But that passion needs to be equated with the capability. If a student is physically unfit and he has the passion to climb the Mount Everest, he has to judge himself whether he is ready physically or not. So passion should be there. At the same time, the capability should be there. And we tell the student, do not fluctuate. If you want to study a career in engineering, it's fine. But you may fluctuate towards medical, but do not again fluctuate towards other things, because too much of fluctuation will be consuming the precious time of your career. So first decide whatever you do and take the advice of your parents. They are there and they remain with you, and they are the people. They always want the good thing in your life. So they'll never deceive you. So take their guidance, but at the end of the day, it's your passion, your career, your life. So take the decision accordingly. Whatever you do, do your best, do well. That's all for the aspiring students.
Okay, sir. So thank you so much. There are really some words of wisdom to me at least. I would like to again thank you for doing this interview with us. It was really nice talking to you.